Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. After praising Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala and sending salutations, peace and blessings upon the best of creation, the jewel and crown of creation, the beloved of Allah Almighty, the coolness to our eyes, the purpose of our lives, the reviver of our hearts, the inspirer to our minds, the most honored one, the most praised one, the most generous one, the most kind one. Undoubtedly, he is the most beautiful one. None other than Sayyiduna Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa ala alihi wa ashabihi wa barak wa sallam. Nabi alayhi salatu wa salam informed and told us that our religion, Al-Islam, is found upon five pillars. Bunya al-Islamu ala khamsin. Islam is found and built on five fundamental pillars. Shahadatu an la ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammadur Rasulullah. That we believe and testify in la ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah, the kalima. This is the absolute foundation, the most important aspect of our religion is our faith and belief in Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Thereafter, Nabi alayhi salatu wa salam said, mentioning this as the first pillar, and establish prayer, fast in the month of Ramadan, give your zakat, charity, and perform Hajj. These are the five pillars of Islam. Of these five pillars, four of them are related to action. One is related to our heart and mind and our soul. The first one is in relation to our iman, our belief, our aqeedah. La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. Praying, fasting, giving charity and performing Hajj, these four are related to a'malul badani, physical actions. If we start with Hajj, for example, we are ordered to perform Hajj once in a lifetime. Hajj is fard upon us once in a lifetime. Zakat is fard on us if we are ashabun nisab. We are sahibe nisab. We have the required amount. We meet the threshold to perform and pay zakat. Otherwise, zakat is not fard on us. Fasting is fard on us. It's an obligation upon us for 1 month in the year, the month of Ramadan, be that 29 or 30 days. From all of these actions, the one we are ordered to perform consistently, regularly on a daily basis, is our salah. Allah Almighty has ordered us to perform salah five times a day, starting in the morning with Fajr and ending at night with Salatul Isha. This is an obligation, a fard, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon His creation, upon those whom believe in Him. Allah Almighty has this right over me and you. It is a haqq of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, therefore this act of worship, this ibadah, falls under the category of huququllah, the rights of Allah. And on the day of Qiyamah, Allah will ask about this. In the Quran, Allah Jalla wa Ala has mentioned salah 67 times. Allah Almighty has mentioned prayer, salah, 67 times in the Quran. And the prayer was obliged upon us. Salah was made fard on us on the night of Al-Isra wal-Mi'raj. When the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam traveled from Masjidul Haram to Masjidul Aqsa, they led all the prophets and messengers in prayer. And when they ascended beyond the seven heavens, and after the meeting with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah gifted Nabi alayhi salat wa salam for this ummah 50 prayers. 50 then was reduced to 45 through the medium of intermediary of the mediation of Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam. Allah has ordered us to pray 50 times. And then when Sayyidina Rasulullah alayhi salam came past the seventh heaven to the sixth heaven, Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam asked Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi salam, what did Allah give to your ummah as a gift? And Nabi alayhi salam said, 50 salawat, 50 prayers. And Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam said, your ummah will not be able to read 50. They will struggle. Therefore, reduce them. Ask Allah to reduce this amount. The Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam went back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and it was reduced from 50 to 45. Then again, when they returned, Sayyidina Musa asked, what has Allah given now? What has it reduced to 45? It's too much for your ummah. Reduce it to 40. Like this, 9 times, Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam went between Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam and Allah jalla wa ala. And between Allah jalla jalaluhu and Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam, it was reduced from 50 to 5. When Nabi alayhi salam came to Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam, and Sayyidina Musa asked, how much has Allah given you now? And said, Allah has given me 5. And Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam said to our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, that your ummah will struggle to perform 5 salah. Ask Allah to reduce it from 5 to less than 5. Such was the knowledge of Sayyidina Musa. He knew what would be our state. And when Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam asked Rasulullah alayhi salam, this was a rahmat on the ummah. This was Allah's mercy on this ummah, that he reduced it from 50 to 5. And Nabi alayhi salam then said to Sayyidina Musa that I am shy to go back to Allah and ask him to reduce. I've been 9 times. And 5 it is. And Nabi alayhi salam said to Sayyidina Musa that whoever reads 5 in my ummah, Allah will give him the ajr of reading 50 salah. Man ja'a bil hasana falahu ashru amthaliha. Allah jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran that whoever performs one good deed, Allah will multiply 10 times and give him the reward of 10 good deeds. Whoever reads one salah in the day, Allah will give him the reward of reading 10 salah in the day. Whoever reads 2, 20. Whoever reads 3, 30. Whoever reads 4, 40. Whoever reads 5 salah a day, Allah Almighty will give him the ajr of reading the equivalent of 50 salah a day. Man ja'a bil hasanati falahu ashru amthaliha. Whoever reads one, whoever does one good deed, Allah will multiply it 10 times. This is the rahmah of Allah on his ummah, on the ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. 50 prayers reduced to 5. Whoever reads 5, Allah will give the reward of 50. You can't get a better deal than this for one prayer. And we see that many people question, why do we pray? What is the reason for praying? What is the hikmah and wisdom? What is the psychology behind prayer? Do we need to pray? Do we have to pray? First and foremost, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordered us to pray. But Allah Almighty is not in need of our prayers. Allah Ta'ala doesn't need my ruku and sujood, and Allah does not need your rukus and sujood. He's ghair muhtaj. He's not muhtaj and in need of anything. He's independent. Allah Almighty is not in need of mine and your worship. So why has He ordered us to worship Him then? He ordered us to worship Him for us. That for us to be in the correct state of mind. For us to be right in the right frame of mind. For us to be spiritually, physically, mentally sound. We need to act upon what Allah has ordered us. Be that fasting in the month of Ramadan. Be that purifying our wealth and giving zakat. Be that performing the pilgrimage Hajj once in a lifetime. Or be that reading our salah daily 5 times. Reading our salah 5 times daily. Allah Almighty has ordered us. Allah Almighty has ordered us. To perform these acts of worship for us, not that He is in need. What will these acts of worship do? They will purify our soul. They will purify our hearts. They will cleanse our minds. These acts of worship, salah specifically, will humble us, make us humble beings. Prayer should not bring arrogance into our hearts. If you are reading 5 times salah and you have an atom's worth of arrogance in your heart, Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said that person will not enter into Jannah. Whoever has an atom's, a mustard seed worth of arrogance inside his heart will not enter into paradise. Paradise is haram upon such a person. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us this. Our Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam informed us this, that we must avoid arrogance at all cost. So prayer should make us humble. It clears the conscience of a person, the nafs. It fights against the ego. Every human has an ego inside them. Whether it's an alter ego, whether it's an ego that influences them. Allah Almighty talks about the nufus in the Quran. Inna an-nafsa la'ammaratun bis-su' in Surah Yusuf. The nafs la'ammaratun bis-su', nafsi ammara bis-su', the nafs which commands or encourages a person to do wrong. There's an aspect within us which drives us towards doing wrong, and shaitan whispers and he plays on that. Nafsi ammara bis-su'. There's nafsi Lawama. Allah Almighty in the Quran talks about nafsul lawama. This is the nafs that after you commit a sin, it's regrets and remorse. It has regret. Why? Why did I do this? I shouldn't have done this. I should have avoided this. This is the biggest problem. Inna nafsul la'ammaratum bisu, nafsul lawama, nafsul mutma'inna. Ya ayyatuhan nafsul mutma'in. The third nafs, the type of nafs is nafsul mutma'in. This is that nafs which is satisfied. It is doing good all the time. That even the ego encourages us to do good. Even the nafs tells us to do good. And Allah Almighty tells us that the one who purifies himself, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ ذَكَّاهَا وَقَدْ خَابَ مَنْ دَسَّاهَا قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ تَذَكَّاهَا وَذَكَّرَ اسْمَ رَبِّهِ فَصَلَّى. The one, he who has purified himself, is successful. Success is for him who has purified his inner. And in order to purify ourselves, it is a condition that we must pray our salah 5 times a day. And then we see another wisdom of praying. That it makes the akhirah of a person better for him. A person's hereafter will become better for him. You pray for your own akhirah. You don't pray for my akhirah. You don't pray for my hereafter. You pray for your hereafter. You pray, you save yourself. You pray, you won't save me. Why? Because prayer is fard on every individual. Reading 5 times salah, this is fardul ayn, not fardul kifaya. Do you know the difference between farz-e ayn and farz-e kifaya? Fardul ayn is that action. And fardul ayn is that action which is obligatory on every individual. It's an individual obligation. You praying salah 5 times a day is fard on you and only you, as it is fard on me and every individual, every Muslim. Fard kifaya is a communal obligation. For example, if somebody passes away and a handful of the members of the Muslim community perform his salatul janaza, that obligation is lifted from everyone. It is not, imagine every Muslim that passed away, you had to go and read his salatul janaza, otherwise it's a sin. That's why it's a communal obligation, not an individual obligation. Great wisdom in the Sharia. There is great hikmah and wisdom inside the rule and law that Allah and His Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam established for the Muslims. So it makes our akhirah better. It is an individual obligation upon each and every one of us that we read our prayers 5 times a day. And most importantly, salah brings us closer to Allah. It brings us close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah Almighty in the Quran told us from amongst the benefits of prayer, أَكِمِ الصَّلَاةَ إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ تَنْهَىٰ أَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ. Establish prayer. Read your salah. Why? إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ تَنْهَىٰ أَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ. Prayer will stop you from evil. It will prevent you from doing bad. If you're praying and still doing bad, then there's no shortage in the prayer. The problem isn't the prayer, the problem is you. How are you reading your prayer? If you aren't reading your prayer correctly, then it will not have the correct effect upon you. In order for salah to have the correct effect upon you, it is necessary that you read your salah correctly. And how can you read your salah correctly if you've never studied how to read salah? Many of our community, Muslim community, learned how to read salah watching our elders pray. And they learned from what their elders prayed. How many of us can stand up and tell us how many fard there are in prayer? How many fard there are in salah? How many wajibat there are in salah? Did you know if you miss a wajib of prayer, a wajib, it is necessary for you to do sajdatul sahaf. You have to make the prostration of forgetfulness at the end of prayer. If you miss a wajib, one very common wajib that we all miss, not illa mashallah, not all of us, but most of us, many of us don't know. You know, it is wajib that when we are in sujood, sajda, that our nose and our forehead touch the ground. Many people I've seen, their forehead is on the ground, their nose is lifted. If your nose is lifted off the ground, when wajib is missed, sajdatul sahw. You have to make the prostration of compensation. You have to compensate for this mistake. Many people don't know these basics of salah. How will your salah benefit you if you don't know how to read salah? A car cannot benefit you if you don't know how to drive it. It is only beneficial if you learn how to drive it, and you must go through your theory and then your practical, and then you need to be qualified. You will receive a certificate to say, MashaAllah, this person knows how to drive. He's passed his driving. He is safe to drive on the roads. It is not easy just to stand on the musalla and lead the prayer if you don't have ilm. This is why it's necessary. That's why the Prophet ﷺ said, طلب العلم فريدة على كل مسلم. Seeking knowledge is fard, an obligation upon every single Muslim. Seeking knowledge is fard on every single Muslim. Every Muslim should learn the very basics of Islam. And learning how to pray is the absolute basic of Islam. Why? Every day you must pray 5 times. For example, in the Hanafi school, because we are of the Hanafi school, we follow the great Imam Abu Hanifa, Nu'man bin Thabit, Al-Imam Al-A'zam radiyallahu an. Al-Imam Al-A'zam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah, he said that when the Imam is leading the prayer, be that the silent prayers or the loud prayers. Fajr is loud, Maghrib is loud, and Isha is loud. Loud meaning the Imam prays out aloud. And the silent prayers are Zuhr and Asr. You don't need to read anything behind the Imam. You don't need to read Suratul Fatiha. You don't need to read Suratul Ikhlas. All you read is Subhanak Allahumma wa bihamdika, and that's it. I know people who regularly read Salah, but they will stand behind the Imam and read Suratul Fatiha. Unless you follow Imam Shafi'i school, Imam Malik school, Imam Ahmed bin Hanbal school, otherwise in the Hanafi school, which all of us, majority of us sat here, 99.9% of us sat here, in the Hanafi school, we don't say Ameen out loud. We say Ameen quietly. We don't read Suratul Fatiha or Surah behind the Imam. We just read Subhanak Allahumma, A'udhu Billahi Minash Shaitanir Rajeem, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, and stop. And the Imam will pray. The recitation of the Imam is the recitation of the Muqtadiyun. If the Imam makes a mistake, he has to compensate. You make a mistake behind the Imam, your salah will continue. These are basics of salah. Many people don't know. Many people don't know that if you excessively move your hand in prayer, your prayer breaks. You must repeat your prayer. People in salah, they will stand, play with their beard, sort out their jubbah, sort out their hats, turbans, whilst they are praying. There shouldn't be no excessive movement in prayer. The ulama write the basic minimum movement. Say you have a runny nose, or say there's something in your eye, or something is stopping you and is distracting you from your prayer. Okay, one movement, two movement, three at the maximum. But to excessively move in prayer, if you move your chest away from the Qibla, your salah breaks. You must start your salah all over again. Tahweelu sadri anil Qibla. Your salah breaks. These are basics people don't know. That's why it is necessary, my brothers, that you study the theory of Islam. You study the theory of prayer. What is theory? Theory is the books. You sit with the teacher and say, take me through my salah. Correct me if my salah is incorrect. Why? On the day of Qiyamah, the first thing Allah is going to ask me is about my salah. أَوَّلُ مَا يُحَاسَبُ بِهِ الْعَبْدُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ يَصَّلَىٰ أَوْ كَمَا قَالَ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ. The first thing Allah will question you on the day of judgment will be about your salah. Did you pray your salah? How many salahs did you pray? And if you had weakness in your prayer, you prayed. That's why it's important that after our fara'id we read sunnah. After the sunnah we read nawafil. For Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said, whoever has a shortage, a shortfall inside his fard prayers, the sunnahs will compensate the shortfall. Whoever has a shortfall in his sunnahs, the nawafil will compensate the sunnahs. This is the wisdom why we read sunnah. We read Jumu'ah, for example, two fard. Many people stand up and walk out. Okay, you might have to go to work. You may be running late. Understandable. You might have a valid excuse. But if you don't have a valid reason, read your sunnahs, then go. For if there's a shortage in the prayer, if there's a shortfall, a shortcoming inside our fara'id, the sunnahs will compensate. If there's a shortcoming in our sunnahs, the nawafil will compensate. This is why, my brothers, it's necessary upon us that we study and learn about salah. These are the basics, absolute basics. There's no point talking about politics and the Conservative Party winning and now becoming the absolute majority in government. That's not going to give me and you no benefit. They are going to do what they're going to do for the next 5 years. Their manifesto is clear for us all. For me and you, in order for us to get ourselves in order, in check, for us to be spiritually healthy, we must start praying 5 times a day salah. Allah is going to ask us about this before whether we voted for Jeremy Corbyn or Boris Johnson. Allah is not going to ask you who did you vote for on the day of Qiyamah. He's not going to ask you about the state of Pakistan's politics. This is not your responsibility. They have their job to do, we have our job. Our job daily is that we please Allah by praying 5 times a day salah. For Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said, and I mentioned a few virtues before I end. الصلوات الخمس والجمعة إلى الجمعة والرمضان إلى رمضان مكفرات لما بينهن إذا اجتنبت الكبائر. نبي عليه الصلاة والسلام said the 5 prayers one after the other, Fajr till Zuhr, Zuhr till Asr, Asr till Maghrib, Maghrib till Isha, the five daily prayers, one Jumu'ah to the next Jumu'ah, one Ramadan to the next Ramadan, will compensate for every minor sin that you have done. If you woke up at Fajr, read Fajr, then you committed a sin, then you woke up and you read Zuhr, or you read Zuhr, and then you, in between you sinned, between Fajr and Zuhr, when you read your Zuhr, Allah will forgive the sins in between. You read Zuhr, then between Asr, you committed sins, Asr will forgive the sins of what was between Fajr, between Zuhr and Asr. Asr and Maghrib, the same in between. Maghrib and Isha, the same in between. Why do we pray five times daily? So daily our sins are cleansed. Allah Almighty forgives our wrongdoings during the day. If you committed a major sin, Salah will not seek forgiveness for that. Salah will not redeem that. The condition for a major sin is that you must do tawbah. You must ask sincerely Allah and repent to Him that, oh Allah, forgive me. Major sins will only be forgiven if you do tawbah. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said and informed, and the way Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam explained, look at the figurative speech that the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam mentioned to the Sahaba. He said, أَرَأَيْتُمْ لَوْ أَنَّ نَهْرًا بِبَابِ أَحَدِكُمْ يَغْتَسِلُ فِيهِ كُلَّ يَوْمٍ خَمْسًا مَا تَقُولُ ذَلِكَ يَبْكَ عَنْ دَرَنِهِ. That if there was a stream or a river flowing outside your house, and five times a day you went inside and washed yourself, will there be any impurity on your body? Nabi alayhi salam asked the Sahaba this question. And the Sahaba said, لَا يَبْقَ عَنْ دَرَنِهِ شَيْئًا. No disease, no illness, no harm, no death will remain on that person. He will be pure and cleansed. He will be purified and cleansed, because five times a day having a shower, imagine five times a day having a shower, you'd smell fragrant, you would look fragrant, everything will be clean. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said, فَذَلِكَ مَثَلُ الصَّلَوَاتِ الْخَمْسِ. That's the example of five prayers. When you pray five times a day salah, it is like you are washing yourself five times a day. It is for your benefit, not for ours. For we believe on the day of judgment, Allah will ask us. And if we are short in our prayers, then what answer will we give to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? This is a right that Allah Almighty has upon each and every one of us. Nabi alayhi salam said, Man hafaza alayha kanat lahu nuran wa burhanun wa najatan yawm al-qiyamah. Whoever protects his prayers, the prayer will be a light for him. It will be evidence for him. And it will be a savior for him and salvation for him on the day of judgment. Those who used to miss their prayers, the Quran tells us, and I conclude on this, كُلُّ نَفْسٍ بِمَا كَسَبَتْ رَهِينَ إِلَّا أَصْحَابَ الْيَمِينَ فِي جَنَّاتٍ يَتَسَاءَلُونَ عَنِ الْمُجْرِمِينَ مَا سَلَكَكُمْ فِي سَقَرْ قَالُوا لَمْ نَكُمْ مِنَ الْمُسَلِّينَ. Allahu Akbar. In Surah Al-Muddathir, every person will be accountable for what he did. Every person will be held to account by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who am I to hold you to account when Allah is going to hold me to account? Who am I to judge you when Allah is the one who will judge me? We must first look at ourselves before we look at others. We must first point fingers at ourselves before we point fingers at anyone else. Every person except the people of the right. People of the right here refers to the people of paradise. They will be in Jannah, يتساءلون. They will be asked there, عن المجرمين. And they will be asking one question, oh Allah, where are the mujrims? Where are the criminals? Where are those who used to do wrong in the dunya? Allah Almighty will say, they will ask then the people of Jahannam, the people of the fire, مَا سَلَكَكُمْ فِي سَكَرْ. Why are you in the hellfire? What is the reason why you are in this hellfire? قَالُوا لَمْ نَكُمْ مِنَ الْمُسَلِّينَ. They won't say that we used to commit zina, adultery, we drank alcohol, we used to gamble, we used to smoke weed, or we used to smoke drugs. No. They said, you know why we are in prayer? The first and foremost reason we are in the fire of hell is because we used to miss our prayers. Do you know why we are in the hellfire? Because we used to miss our prayers. We didn't pray our salah. By us not praying our salah, we are now being punished in the fire of Jahannam. Until Allah removes this punishment, we will not enter paradise. My brothers, these verses of the Quran are enough warning for me and you to start praying 5 times salah. In the winter, it is so easy to read salah. Asr begins at 2 o'clock, for example. Straight after, you can read your Salatul Asr. Maghrib is around 3:50, less than that maybe. Isha is around 6 o'clock. Around 5:30, it begins. From 6, 7 in the morning till 5, all your salahs are done. Each salah takes 5 minutes. Times each by 5, 25, 30, 45 minutes tops. Out of 24 hours, you can't take 1 hour out for Allah. You can't give Allah 1 hour of your time. Are you so busy? Has the iPhone taken over your life so much? Has the dunya and money and mortgages taken your life? Thank Allah for what He's given you. And one of the best forms of thanking Allah is doing sajda to Him. May Allah Almighty make us from those who pray. May we have the tawfiq to read 5 times salah. May Allah forgive us for our sins. Wa akulu qawli hadha. Astaghfirullah li wa lakum. Wa akhru da'wayan. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.